In the woods of Cock County, Tennessee, Mark Digger and their young pupil embark on the righteous path to Heritage Tennessee Liquor.
Is this what you cooked that liquor on?
Yes, it is. It's...
That's your papaw's still.
That's papaw's old still right there. My still came from my grandpa's shed. The fact that it was still intact and has made it this many years and give me a lot of respect for my papaw because shows me that he knows how to build a still.
I mean, honestly, this is a piece of moonshine history.
It's called a laundry kettle, and it's a Prohibition-era still. They sold these wash kettles in all your mail-order catalogs, and they were made out of copper, so people were actually sealing them up and making liquor out of them. I don't want to bust your bubble, but we ain't gonna use this little feller. Number one, that's probably lead solder. That make you go blind.
Lead solder is a no-no. It's toxic. They didn't know this then, and Kimbel don't know it now. But this can't ever be used for making liquor again, ever. I tell you something, no young feller. The fact that you got a half a gallon of alcohol out of that thing right there, that's pretty impressive, Digger.
Yeah, that's highly impressive.
Did you like it good enough to want to continue?
Oh, I'd love to continue on it. Do it the right way.
All right, show us what kind of ingredients you used there.
Hot rise, self-rising cornmeal. Good for cornbread, bad for liquor. Simply because all the baking soda and everything that's in there, you don't want that. That'll jeopardize your damn fermentation.
Did you put all these bags in there in this one run?
Yes.
Ain't no wonder.
Damn, you was cooking damn porridge. General rule, quarter pound a meal to a gallon. That'd get you a good strong mash.
And a pound of sugar per gallon. You know, Kimbel has made no mistake at all that Digger and myself haven't made before ourselves. You know, that's how you learn. Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. You seem like you want to learn.
Yes, I do. I'm willing to learn how to do any of it.
Well, Digger's good with it. You good with it?
Hell yeah.
You don't know what I'm going to say yet.
Hell, I know exactly what you're going to say. I got ESPN, three other sports channels. I know what's on your mind.
Do you think it's something you want to do, Kim? You're the kind of young man we want to help.
Exactly.
So we're going to try to show you the proper way.
Might even benefit us one of these days. You never know.
Getting tips from Mark and Digger, it's a really big deal to me. And I'm excited to figure out the right way to mash in. I want to know how to do it.
All right. Let's learn how to make a little mash, our puss. Well, we're going to show Kimbel how to make a proper mash. He didn't know no better, so we've rounded up what we need to show him a proper way to do it.
You got a creek down here or spring?
Spring.
You got pretty decent pressure.
It's got pretty good pressure coming. I'll tell you something now. When you start this, once you bite this bullet, it's going to be in your system, your blood, son. Rest of your life, you won't ever be able to shake it.
I trust what these guys are teaching me. They obviously know what they're doing, and I've heard that they're the best to ever do it.
Light that far.
You got a lighter?
You come in here to make liquor and you didn't bring a lighter.
No, I didn't.
Don't burn all the hair off your knuckles.
I probably will.
Here we go. Now, if you was doing this, what would be your very next step?
Put my cornmeal in the barrel.
And
my sugar in the barrel.
That's right. Now that's just coarse ground white corn is what that is. It don't gum up in you hot like that fine cornmeal you got.
Okay. Mark and Digger got me different ingredients. They got me the correct cornmeal and helped me figure out exactly how much water I need. I'm more than embarrassed on all the mistakes that I've made, but you learn from your mistakes.
But now as a rule, well, you gotta learn to take a lid off the bucket first. Keep an eye on him, Digger.
I'm gonna watch him. Leave you about that much of it in the bottom. Kimbel's more than eager to learn this process. We're more than willing to teach him. And this mash we're fixed to make, it's gonna be leaps and bounds over what he made on that previous run.
Reckon he's excited? Look at him, he's grinning like a damn jackass eating sour.
Well, I'm excited for him. Well, this water's where it needs to be to melt that sugar.
Don't burn his damn self, boys.
And we're gonna take it easy here.
All right. Kimbel, he's doing a very good job, I think. His eagerness to learn is obvious.
Don't have to stir it hard.
I mean, it's not rocket science. He don't have to be a genius to get this. But he does have to pay attention, listen to what we're telling him. I wish I had an old still like that blown to my papa.
Yeah, all I've got is his release papers.
His papa would either cut his nuts out or be proud of him.
One of the t'other.
What'd you say he'd do, our son?
I'd say he'd probably be proud of him.
You think he'd be proud of you?
Probably.
Good. I'm telling you, that's gonna be a good looking mice, son.
Now, take him to yeast. One at a time, dump them in there and stir them in. Get them good mixed up.
It's corny. It's going to be.
That's
going to
be some fine liquor. I'm here to tell you.
We got my mash finished today, and I'm going to come back every day, and I'm going to check it and stir it. I feel honored to have them to want to teach me how to do this, and not everybody would.
And you got one other chore to get done before we come back. Take your papa's old still, put it back in the shed.
All right.
They always said that lead paint hurts you.
I ate 312 number two yellow pencils.
What are you doing there, Cool Breeze?
Nothing much.
Well, we got a surprise for you.
Digger's got you something.
You wasn't kidding me, was you?
Get you a little better liquor coming out.
In Cock County, Tennessee, after lending some veteran guidance, Mark and Digger are waiting to see if Kimbel has what it takes to claim a piece of the proud Moonshiner heritage.
You think that mash is ready?
Let's take a look at it.
Ready?
It's bitter.
Oh, yeah.
I believe you've passed your first down test.
Kimbel is paying attention to what we're telling him. Everything we told him to look for, it's happened in this mash. It's ready to run, and he's learned. That's the whole point of all this. Now you got to get that pot set up. You'll learn this deal just like you've learned your woman. Well, let's get some mash in it. Is it filling up good? Anything that you do, whether it's making marshmallows or making liquor, it's attention to detail.
I didn't realize that was still wide open.
It goes to show you got to double check everything.
That's right.
It happens to us, it happens to everybody. All right. Crank that burner up there. You remember your lighting device today?
Yes, I did.
All right. You know, lighting that pot, that's the point of no return. You're breaking the law from one end to the other. Your heart goes to racing. You've stepped into uncharted territory. Hand him that jar of backing.
There you go.
Now, that's your backing. That's low-proof liquor.
It'll yield you a little bit more.
Well, get your cap in place, and we'll go on to the next lesson. Plumber, buddy. You can roll you out a worm head, mash that into place.
My first run, I didn't know I was supposed to do this, so I had steam coming out everywhere.
As you start making steam in your pot, you can feel it. It'll get warm. We showed Kimbel how to get warm in sections. Once it starts actually putting steam into the thump keg, we told him about the thump keg boogie.
You see that thump keg right there? Watch the top on it. It's got a heartbeat. It's where that steam's starting to come over. That's your liquor getting over in there.
Pretty neat.
When he sees this, he knows he's getting close.
There you go.
There it is. It's running.
Hell yeah.
Done it.
You can tell by the expression on Kimball's face. For a rookie moonshiner, this is a big moment right here.
Dump that little bit out right there.
That's called heads. They ain't no count. Make your head hurt.
Here's what we do now.
See how that liquor just run dribbles right over them fire coals?
Uh-huh.
That's a getting all that stuff out of it.
I think you're making liquor, son.
Feel pretty freaking good.
He was just grinning from ear to ear. I'm sure his excitement, because I know what this meant to me when I was first learning.
That right there is probably 140 proof liquor.
A hell of a lot better than what I made.
Damn sight clearer, ain't it?
Yeah.
It caught him off guard. He expected to be weak like that first liquor he made, but no, he's making real liquor now. Yeah. All right, shake it good. And if you can count to 10, about all them bubbles are gone, you got 100 proof liquor.
Okay.
You know, he's got a long life ahead of him, and if this is something he enjoys, Kimball's got the potential of being an outstanding liquor man for a lot of years.
Well, it's still, if you like it, we might be pressed to let go of it.
All right, I mean, how much are you talking for?
Well, it's $800 still. So I tell you what you do. Every run you make, you scavenge just a quart out of it, and you put it in a box. When you get 12, you bring us that box.
That sounds like a pretty good deal to me.
Don't make liquor, you start bringing liquor, we gonna
it don't count.
In your ice. If this craft is gonna carry through the next generations, it's up to people like Kimbel to pick it up and learn. I couldn't be any more pleased with the young man. We're gonna take this jar as our down payment.
Congratulations on your first successful run of liquor.
I believe we've created us a damn fine liquor man right over here.
Yeah.